I just want to show Sode Tsuri-Komi Goshi, one of my old favourites, and show it here with Phil. Just moving my body back here like this and drawing, moving the body back and then drawing the circle here and then stepping in. So from here, moving my body back. Stepping to the side and drawing and skipping up. Sneaky entry up the side. So, here. I used to work at Chimata a lot on this side. So I would work at Chimata here, like that, and then they would lean back the opposite way, so that I couldn't do a Chimata. And so then I would step out this way and then do the Sode Tsuri-Komi Goshi in there. So step out this way here and step into Sode Tsuri. Now when they block Sode Tsuri by pushing hard here, so as I come in, they just keep their elbow low here, I would just do Uki Goshi. You start getting good at it, people start dropping your elbow. As soon as you even pretend to come in, they start dropping their elbow. And so how I solved that problem was, I wouldn't lift with the arm, I'd just stroke the shoulder and draw it over my head. So that, I don't lift, I just draw it. So here, from here, see how I'm keeping it still, basically, I'm just fixing it to my body, yeah. And from here, into my legs. So there's minimal movement from my arm, just shrugs, again to draw the body out. So this arm is extended, it's weakest when the arm's extended. And then from there I can usually rip that grip and push it through. Sometimes it's quite good to offer double, to push your arms across, like this here. A double sleeve, but you hold the hand down and then they go to grab the grip, and as they go you pull it in. That works quite well. So you just push your hand down and then they go to grab the grip, and as they go you throw. So you can make that one even better by just tearing the grip off and push it down and then go straight into it. So sometimes here I'll rip the grip right off here, just here, and